You are listening to the American Urbex Podcast. American Urbex advocates responsible urban exploration in the name of education, preservation, and adventure. You can find maps, detailed research, and photos from our explorations at AmericanUrbex.com. You are listening to episode 27 of the American Urbex Podcast. My name is Ken Fager, and I realize that it's been quite a long hiatus. I've been honestly creatively stumped. Over the past few months, I've explored a lot of locations that really aren't that interesting. You see, that fine urbex skill, that spider sense for abandoned locations that I developed in the Midwest, doesn't really work in the Appalachian regions. Not so much, anyways. I've been able to find things, sniff out abandoned warehouses, farms, even abandoned houses for that matter, but they really haven't been that interesting. Most of them have been devoid of any sort of interesting subject matter to photograph. Perhaps even worse is that a lot of these locations don't really have a well-documented history behind them. So if these locations don't have any interesting subject matter to photograph and don't have any interesting history to research, then I don't really have anything to write about. And that can be demotivating at times. To make matters worse, I seem to have run into more security than normal. A couple of locations were alarmed, much to my surprise, as I was in them, and as I left them in a hurry. Some security guards that I have met were less than friendly. However, most have been simply just doing their jobs. Now, if you urban explore long enough, eventually you're going to run into an authority figure with a legitimate badge, with legitimate authority behind it. You're going to run into the police sooner or later. I may be particularly fortunate in that my interactions with the authorities have generally gone my way. They usually ask, "What are you doing here?" At which point I explain, "I'm just taking photos." Then they tell me that I'm probably trespassing. At which point I acknowledge that, "Oh, I hadn't considered that. Maybe I am trespassing." Then they tell me, "You should probably leave." At which point I do. Some interactions with police, though, are a little bit more involved, such as one I had a few months ago. Now, I'm going to give you a little background information about this location. It's about 100 miles away from me, so I had quite a drive in the morning to get there. I had actually been there before. It's a top-tier urbex location. In fact, it's one of my favorite explorations of all time. So I'm very excited to be back. The last time that I was there, I had seen security, and security had seen me, but didn't bother to stop. When I got to the location this time, I discovered security wasn't really security, but actually police patrolling the area. An officer had seen me and had driven past in his vehicle. I waved to him, and he waved to me. I continued on down the sidewalk. As I continued on down the sidewalk, I saw a building I wanted to take a picture of, so I pulled my DSLR camera out, and I snapped away. It's at this point that the officer whips his car around and decides to pull up to me and get out of his vehicle. The officer says that I can't be there, that I shouldn't be taking photos, and that I'm possibly trespassing. It's at that point that I take out my cell phone and I start recording video. There's a few seconds that elapse, but eventually the video picks up soon after we begin.
I'm informing you that you can't take these pictures of these buildings, okay? Now, like I said, I can't let you leave with that camera and those pictures in it. I'm going to need you to delete those pictures out of that camera before you leave.
Okay.
Now, I just need you to cooperate with me now because, I mean, like I said, you are trespassing, so that's an arrestable offense. You know that, right? And I'm not trying to arrest you. I'm not trying to detain you. All I want you to do is let me see your driver's license. I'm going to run it real quick, and you delete the pictures. That's it. And you'll be on your way. Come on, man.
Did you catch that audible sigh? It's at this point that I am doing the mental math in my head. I'm not really certain if trespassing is an arrestable offense where I am. But that's besides the point. I can't debate this officer on this because, one, I don't know the law, and two, I am not a lawyer, and three, nor would I ever pretend to be. However, remember that I am recording this situation on video. The Supreme Court has affirmed over and over and over again that in your interactions with police, it is okay to record them as they go about their public duties. So I keep the camera rolling.
Pull out my ID. There you go.
Thank you, sir. Okay. All right. Well, hold tight for me, man.
Can I have your name, officer?
Officer.
Now, I don't actually think that I've committed a crime at this point. I'm standing on a public sidewalk, and while I'm on that sidewalk, I've taken a picture of a building that is clearly in plain view. I'm not about to argue those points, though, with this officer. I give him my ID readily, and he calls the information in.
So you came all the way from to see the campus, or you was in the area or something?
I drive around, I take photos.
Okay.
A lot
like
of things.
Like I'm telling you, man, we get that a lot, and I'm not saying that you're in any trouble so far. I mean, you could be, but we don't do that. You know, we understand that people don't know, okay? So all we have to do, we get a call that somebody's out here, okay? I roll past you, and in a couple seconds that I roll past you, I already got a call that you was out here, okay? So we have to get you to delete the pictures, and then if you go over here to this administration building, they do tours and all kind of stuff, man. You walk through the buildings, you take as many pictures as you want to. I mean, it's real easy. It's just, you know, I can't let you leave with the pictures and the camera, man.
If you listen to the officer closely, he said that he got a call that I had been on the campus just a few seconds after he had rolled by. I find this highly suspect, as it's a weekend. There isn't anyone else around. I also doubt that a call was placed because, again, I'm merely walking on the sidewalk. There isn't anything suspicious. The officer had seen me when I was walking on the sidewalk and originally did nothing. It really wasn't until I pulled my camera out that he decided to come back and interact with me. The officer also says that if I go to the administration, that I can get a tour and go inside the buildings and take as many photos as I want. I don't think that's true, as most of these buildings are abandoned and are probably an insurance liability. The officer also says that he isn't going to let me leave with the two pictures that I have taken with my camera. During the time that we are waiting for radio dispatch to get back to the officer with information, a second officer arrives on the scene. This is the voice of that second officer speaking to me.
They said, you gotta get permission. Just to stay properly and take the pictures.
I was not aware of that previously. I was told to delete the pictures.
I mean, you have to physically see delete the pictures.
Okay. I will do that. I disagree with that, but I'm not going to fight that argument right now. So I'm going to take my camera out of my bag. Am I being detained?
No. As of right now, you're not being detained. We just wanted your information so you don't stay properly.
Okay.
As of right now, you're not being detained.
Okay. Well, I'm going to take my bag off, and then I took two pictures.
Now, during the week, you know what a D-Mates administration building is?
I don't, but
right,
I could find it.
Right here, the next building, the Overby building, you get permission to take the pictures.
Okay, this is my DSLR. That's the church right there.
You gonna delete that for me?
Erase. And that's the second one. And I'm doing this under protest.
Okay.
And then the card's empty.
I understand that. Alright.
Thank you. And what was your name, officer?
At this point, I'm not really out that much by deleting two photos off my camera. In fact, they weren't even really that great, and churches really aren't my thing. It is pretty clear, though, at this point, that if I stick around and show my face again, they are going to arrest me. So I'm going to have to leave. I'm not going to press the issue. I'm going to get out of there, and I'm going to go about my day.
All right, now, if I may, can I just walk towards the main gate and leave?
We're going to go ahead and let you go ahead and go, man. But like I said, it's easy to give permission to be able to take the pictures, man. We're not trying to hassle you, and it's not like we're treating you any different than anybody else. You know, we just, that's what we are told to do. We're doing our job, man. But,
okay, I'm not going to tell you how to do your job.
You know, I understand, because the architect probably won't find us nowhere else.
Yeah, I like architecture, and I like the period, too, so.
Yeah. So, and you understand that, and we do have people that get permission, and they're able to come out here and take pictures. Once you get permission, get it signed off by a director, you're allowed to take pictures.
I'm just gonna walk down the sidewalk, and then I'm gonna take a right, and I'm gonna head towards the main gate.
Okay.
All right. Thanks.
The officer again reiterates that it is possible to get permission to shoot there. I'm not really gonna follow up on this, as I've already shot at this location previously without permission. So if I go to the administration and supposedly ask, "Hey, can I get permission to shoot in here?" they may put two and two together, and who knows what that could lead to. I tried looking for people who have had permission to shoot at this location, but I haven't found any to this date. I could be wrong. They could give out passes for the day, but I'm just not too certain. Upon further reflection of this whole interaction, there's something that strikes me. The officers are telling me that I can't take pictures on the property, but I'm recording moving pictures this entire time with my camera on my cell phone. It is apparently illegal for me to take pictures with my DSLR, but the camera on my phone, entirely okay. I don't understand it, but I can't really question it in the moment. What did I do the rest of the day? Well, after leaving that property, I went about the area and searched for new things. It's try to make the best of a bad situation. Which, come to think about it, wasn't really a bad situation at all. Yes, the officers had caught me, but they also let me go. I didn't exactly agree with some of the points that they were trying to make, but I wasn't going to fight them. My own goal was to de-escalate the situation so that they would have no reason to pull me in, to give me a fine. I just gave them every reason to let me go. I was harmless, just somebody who walked onto the property, didn't know he wasn't supposed to be there. Of course, this is a conceit on my part. I know I'm not really supposed to be there, and the officers are just doing their job. I may not be walking away with the photos that I want for the day, but I am coming back with something else. I'm coming back with a recording of my interaction with the police that I can share with other urban explorers. Overall, I would categorize this interaction with the police as positive. There are two obvious reasons for that. I didn't have a fine, and I wasn't arrested. But there are less obvious reasons. The situation didn't escalate. The police asked for cooperation, and I gave it to them. They respected me, and I respected them back. Although I disagreed with some of the things that they were telling me, I really wasn't in a situation where I had the power to argue those things. What I think really gave me the power, though, was the fact that I had taken my camera out and was recording the entire thing. Again, you have the right to record your interaction with police, or any police action that is on public property. I'm not going to hypothesize how the situation could have turned against me had I not been recording video. There are too many variables involved. Again, too many hypotheticals. I'm also not offering any sort of legal advice. Your interaction with police may be different. In fact, every situation is going to be different. There are some ways that you can control the situation, however. Just remember to stay calm and keep that camera rolling. Thank you for listening to the American Urbex podcast. Be sure to explore AmericanUrbex.com to keep tabs on our latest Urbex outings. Twitter users can get real-time updates by following @AmericanUrbex. If you're a Facebook user, we've got you covered at facebook.com/AmericanUrbex. If you have a comment or question for American Urbex, please send them to AmericanUrbex@gmail.com.